Hey everyone, Danny here with Vader Dad Designs. Today let's talk about the Scout Trooper helmet that I made using a free STL file. This is one of my favorite prints I've done so far, and I'll be sharing the STL file with you so you can make your own too. I will go through my steps to making a smooth surface before painting, which should help you on your next print as well. I will give my review of the printing, the finishing, and the final build of this free STL file, and I will show you how I fixed a major issue that I ran into while using these files. Alright, let's get started. First, I separated the STL into four files using mesh mixer. The front and the back of the helmet, the two bolts, and the mouthpiece. Overall, this print took about 120 hours on my Ender 3 Max Neo. For the printing, I rated a 7 out of 10. I would have liked the parts to be separate files to make it easier to slice. I go through 7 steps to smooth out a print before painting. The first step will be the first sanding pass. I use 120 grit sandpaper over the whole helmet. This is just a quick pass and the print will still be rough after sanding, but that's okay at this point. The next step will help cut down a lot of the sanding time. Step 2 is Bondo glaze and spot putty. During this step, make sure that you're using gloves and are in a well-ventilated area. I apply some spot putty onto the print. Then I use a rubber spatula to spread a thin layer evenly over the helmet parts. Bondo has a 3-pack of these available. Whatever spatula you use needs to be flexible to get around curves. For tighter areas, it's easier to use your fingers to spread the putty. Allow it to dry completely before starting the next step. Which brings me to step 3, sanding again. This time I'm using the 220 grit sandpaper. It's much easier to sand the spot putty than it is to sand the PLA filament. You are ready for the next step once you start to see the high areas of the layer lines. But if there are still some rough areas, you will want to go over them again with more putty and another pass of sanding. Now it is much smoother than after the first sanding pass. On to step 4. Filler primer. This primer will fill in the low areas and will make your final print even smoother. I'm done with the first layer of primer. You can see it's looking pretty smooth now. Unfortunately, one thing I noticed on the hinge, when you open and close it, it doesn't stay in place. I'm going to use the Dremel to grind it down here and there, and that should help that open up a little easier. It was a little late for me, so unfortunately I am having to grind these areas down with the Dremel. If you are able to use a 3D modeling program like Blender or Fusion 360, I would recommend making adjustments before printing. Here are the adjustments that I made to the front and back of the helmet. Luckily, it still worked out with this method. The helmet opens and closes just fine. Step 5 is a third sanding pass. Now I'm using a 400 grit sandpaper to sand down the primer. By now your print should be getting really smooth and will most likely only have a few low areas left. And step 6 is another pass of filler primer. The helmet is much smoother now and almost ready to paint. The second pass of primer should fill in the rest of the low areas. Before that we have step 7, a wet sanding pass. I'm using an 800 grit sandpaper and dipping it in water. This will now give you a really smooth surface to paint on. But first you will need to wipe it down and let it completely dry. Now that these steps are done, the helmet is ready for painting. I did 2 coats of white paint on both halves of the helmet, allowing it to dry in between coats. I also did 1 coat of gray on the 2 bolts and the mouthpiece. After the paint is dry, I add 2 coats of clear gloss to give the helmet an extra shine. It also adds a layer of protection to prevent scratching. Let's add some details to this helmet now. I am painting black around the mouthpiece area and on the sides here. Since I'm not the best painter, I'm using a Cricut to make stickers for the finer details. You can paint these instead, but if you have a Cricut, I recommend using it because these stickers turned out really nice. I used a free program called Inkscape to design and create the files for these stickers. After cutting them on the Cricut, you just peel off the excess, then apply the transfer tape, then stick them onto the helmet. For the finishing, I rate this model a 6 out of 10. The hinge not fitting correctly was the major issue here. I'm gluing the mouthpiece into place using a super glue gel. For the inside of the helmet, I bought a pack of airsoft helmet pads on Amazon. I attach the Velcro where I want to add the pads, and then just put them in place. All right, so the last steps are putting the bolts into the hinges. Now it'll open up. And also adding this visor. If you want to see how I did that, check out this video right here. Thank you for watching.